Stinke mit der Geissene.
No, no, è buono, dice Daniele. Նախ միջարցել եմ, ովքեր անգեր են ողոսին, հոսիկան հասկանան ավելի շատ, գրնակը ձեր տևերը, ոչ մի բան չեն հասկանար անգեր են, գամ,
ինկեր,
ես մի կիչ ձեզի, դժվարության մեջ միլիտքիմ, որովհետև պրովոկատիվ խոսքեր միլուն են ամում։ Նախ ուրեմ են գուզի ես էլ, որ ծեղասպանությունը, նախ մեր ծեղասպանությունը ծեղասպանություն է, դժպաղտապար, ինչպես ով բիժին հասավ, այդ ուրենքը, որ առաջին անգամ լարով ծեղասպանությունը ուրեմ են դեվինիսյոն լվավ, ուրեմ են 1948-ին էր, չեմ, և մինչև այսօր միան երկու դեպքեր ծեղասպանության կոչվեցան, ուրեմ են Ռուանդայից, և Սրեբրենիչա, Սերբիայի, Բոսնիայի, բայց մի մասը, ոչ թե ամբողջ Բոսնիայի սպանությունները, մի այն, Հոլոկոստը շոյան երբեք ժենոսիդ չի վարազեց, այսինքն ուրիշ ուրիշներ չի կան, և պատճառը շատ հեշտ է, այդ 1948-ին կոնվենցիան ռետրոակտիվ չէր, չեք կարող հետատարձում չի գա։ Եվ դժպաղտապար այդ դոկտրինը վերջապես, այսինքն ոչ է վերջապես անցյալ տարի գրգին միջազգային ուրեմն տալարանը, International Court of Justice, դենհագի է տադարանը, որ ուրեմ են միչ բետությունների է տադարանը, որ վիժինը նշեց մի կիչ առաջ, Քրոասիա Սերբիայի թեմ ուրեմ են որոշեց, որ ռետրոակտիվ ուրեմ են ուշչունի այդ կոնվենցիան։ Ուրեմ են հիմա ինչու այսոր մասին կոխոսնեմ, որովհետև իվերջո ժենոսիդը ինչ է, this is a crime, սպանություն է, ուրեմ են կրեական օրենքի գվերածվի։ Եվ կրեական օրենքը ինչպես վիժինը սավ, միայն անձերի, անհատների գտատաբարդել, գբնդը և հետո գտատել։ Եվ այսօր չի գա մարդիկ ուրեմ են տադելում։ Ուրեմ են պան չէ ժենոսիդը լա կրիմ կոնտրոլումանիտը լա, այսինքն այսօր կրեական տադավարությունը this is not relevant, ինչպես կսվի։
Ամիջական գապչունի։
Ամիջական գապչունի, ոկե։ Հիմա ինչ ես էլ է, does it mean that we cannot have an action against Turkey for the crimes they have committed? And in fact, we can. There is a possibility. There is a specific branch of the international law which enables this, which is the law of international responsibility for illicit wrongs, I mean for wrongs committed. Ինչպես բիդի գարողանաս տակման են ասին։
Ուրեմն գսետը մենք այսօր հնարավորություն ունինք միջազգային օրենքի մեկ դա պերագոգ դակորձելով այն ան միջազգային պատասխանատվության կամ անջիշտ արարքներու կամ աբորինի արարքներու հետևանքով միջազգային պատասխանատվություն կարաճանա եւ անոր հետևանքով կարելի է պետությունները պատասխանատու ճանչման
as corpus 2001-ին մշակվեց ուրեմն մագի հադուկ անձնաժողովի մոտ եւ այն հետաքրքրությունը ա դե որ տեմպորալ հարցիկա ժամանակավոր ուրեմն հարցիկա գտնա վերաբերի շատ հերու ուրեմն դեպքերից այդ օրենքի ուրեմն կորպուսը պետք է որ միայն աբացուցել որ այդ պետությունը այդ ուրեմն սխալը wrongs how do you say well it's more than սխալից մի քիչ ավելի է անձակորձությունները ուրեմն ըրաձե եւ ինչ տեսակ անձակորձություններ ուրեմն gross violations of human rights
մարդկային իրավանց տաժանպրնություններ իրականացուցած
կամ gross violations of international humanitarian law
կամ միջազգային օրենքի մարդասիրական օրենքի մարդասիրական օրենքի բռնապարումներ կամ տաժան վայրակ ոտնահարումներ կատարած
Եվ ուրեմն աս գարելությունը կա, բայց հիմա ինչպես նշվեց առաջ, հոստ պետությունի հարց կա, որովհետև այդ օրենքը գտնակ ուրեմն Դեն Հագի դատարանի մոտ բերել, և պետություն չունեինք, անշուշտ 1915-ին, բայց ուրիշ գարելություն կա պետք է որ ուրեմն all the descendants of victims այսինքն մենք զոհերի ժառանգորդները կգրնան հավաքվիլ մի ուրեմն գազմի մեջ եւ ոյևի պետություն Ուրիշ պետություն ոչ միայն Հայաստանը գրնա միանալ այդ to this action
այդ
օքե որբեսի Թուրքիային անդեպ ուրեմն դա prosecution ոչ թե prosecution բայց to engage the responsibility of Turkey
պատասխանատվության հրավիրեն, պատասխանատվության կանչեն Թուրքիան։
Եվ հոս շատ հետաքրքիր հարց է, որովհետև արդեն գտնա աշխատանքային դաշտ նախ Հայաստանի կառավարություն համոզել ամենին դժվարն է։ Եվ եթե որ համոզեցիք, լոբեինգ անել գլխավոր երիտները, որ մեր ձեռասպանության մեջ ոյևէ տեր ունեցան տարբեր ձևով, Գերմանիան, Ֆրանսան, Մեծ Բրիտանիան, Միացյալ Նահանգները, որպեսի այդ ուղղությամբ ուրեմն աջակցին այդ պրոցեսը, ինչու որովհետև հոս this is not the problem of genocide recognition. We don't ask Turkey to recognize the genocide. We engage their responsibility for what they have done. To claim reparations. Ուրեմն հոս գուկամ երկրորդ բաժինին. What is reparation? Because everybody now in diaspora in Armenia, everybody is talking about reparations. What does it mean? So, first of all, you have individual claims and you have collective claims. Okay, individual claims. Everybody has the right to get back his property, his belongings, and lands, and so on. But the collective harm made to the Armenian nation, the collective properties, churches, hospitals, schools. This is another chapter. This is another another issue. That's the first point: individual, collective. And in a case like the Armenian genocide, hundreds years after the crimes, both claims will be interrelated. I mean, this is very difficult today for individuals to claim something that they will have much difficulty to prove and also to evaluate the damage. The second aspect is about the the second aspect of this procedure is to create a database of all the victims. We need to establish a database of all the victims of all the assets as far as we can, and in order to prove the scope of the damages, of the harm.
Ուրեմն շատ արագ ինչ որ աս վերջին 2-3 վայրկյանվա ընթացքին արտահայտվեցա, գսե թե հիմնական փոխհատուցման մասին կխոսենք, սակայն յուրաքանչյուրս տարբեր պատկերացում ունի փոխհատուցումի, իսկ Թուրքիի մեջ տարբեր պատկերացում կա, Հայաստանի մեջ տարբեր գարձիկներ կհնչեն այս առումով, հիմնական երկու տեսակի փոխհատուցում կա, առաջինը անհատական, որ մարդիկ անհատապես գրնան պահանջել իրենց կալվածները, ինչ որ ունեին, իրենց նախնիները եւ այլն, իսկ երկրորդը հավաքական կալվածներու բարական է, եկեղեցիներ, դպրոցներ, հիվանդանոցներ. Երկրորդ խնդիրը այս հարցի մեջ զոհերու դատաբեյս ունենալն է, զոհերու ըստեմարան ունենալն է, որ ով որոնք էին, ինչ էին, ուր գեին եւ այլն եւ այլն, այդ մեկը ունելը շատ կարեւոր է մստ։ Եվ գսեթ է հավաքական եւ անհատական պահանջները այսօր, որովհետեւ 100 տարի անցած է ոճակորձության վրա, փող կապակցված են եւ իրարու հետ ամիջական կապ ունին։
And then we come to another aspect of a which is the material reparations and the moral reparations. Ուրեմն նյութական եւ բարոյական եւ հոս ուրեմն պետք է որ ցեզի բացատրեմ ինչ է միջազգային օրենքով reparation. What is reparation? So it is all written in the international principles of international law. So first of all, this is restitution. What means restitution? Restitution means that the state which is responsible, or the entity which is responsible for the crimes, has to give back your properties or your let's say environment like it was before a crime is committed. But not only, now there is some case law, so jurisprudence, which requires that not only restitution but also to repair the situation which couldn't happen. I mean, and this is one of the aspects that one group in the United States studied. He studied what would have been the Armenian nation in Turkey if this crime didn't happen? What would have been the population of Armenians in Turkey? What would have been their wealth? Ինչ կարված են գուգունենային այսօր, եթե... So, restitution is that. So, to give back as it was before, but now, 100 years after, normally, I say normally, because then we will see that we need to be reasonable, we can also consider that what we have lost and what would could have been the situation of Armenians today without this genocide. So if restitution is not possible, then we come to the second aspect, which is compensation. Compensation is financial.
Restitution in massing same te okay. Ուրեմն շատ արագ կսեմ restitution in բարական, restitution-ը վերականգնում կնշանակի, այսինքն փոխադրումը միջազգային օրենքին համաձայն պետք է վերաթարցնել իրավիճակը այնպես ինչպես որ էր նախքան ոչերին կորցածությունը. Իսկ եթե կարելի չէ, անհնար է ոչերին կորցածությունը մեկ, նախքան, այսինքն ոչերին կորցածությունը ինչպես էր պատկերը այդպես վերաթարցնել. Երկրորդ գսերդեն, թե եթե ոչիրը չպատահեր, տվյալ հասարակությունը կամ տվյալ անձիկ ինչ վիճակի կհասնեին, ուր կլնային, ինչ կալվածներ ունենային, ինչ հարստություն, ինչ ներուժ եւ այլն։ Երբ որ այս երկուքը կարելի չէ իրականացնել, այսինքն երբ որ կարելի չէ վերաթարցնել գացությունը ինչպես որ էր նախքան ոչրակորձությունը եւ կարելի չէ չափել, թե այս 100 տարվա ընթացքին որքան պիտի լար հայության թիվը, ուժագանությունը, պատկերը, տվյալները եւ այլն, անցնենք երկրորդ փոխհատուցման եղանակին, որ այս վարակային նյութական հատուցումն է։
Before going to the third pillar of this reparation process, here I want to say that we have many materials in hand for this compensation. First of all, maybe some of you know that, but at the Peace Conference of Paris in 1919, the Armenian delegation has presented claims for reparations of the genocide. And the number of victims which have been introduced to the peace conference was 1,100,000 people, plus 30,000 soldiers, Armenian soldiers dead in the Ottoman army, I mean massacred in the Ottoman army. That's first. Secondly, they have also evaluated all the damages and lost properties from Armenians. And at this conference, so the total evaluation only for 1915-1916, I'm not talking about Gilgia and Smirn losses. The total reparations sum was 19 billion franc. It was evaluated in French francs. Today, if we are using modern methods for re-evaluating this amount of reparations of compensation, so we reach, according to the method, between 50 and 90 billion dollars. Okay?
Վերջին բաժինով սա որ ինչպես որ գիտենք Փարիզի վերահաջողին հայությունը բանկներով կամ տվյալներով ներկայացավ եւ փոխանցեց թե զոհերուն տիպը 1.5 միլիոներ իսկ 30,000 Օսմանյան գայստության մեծ ծառայող զինվորներ սպանված են եւ օրին արժեվորում կատարվեցավ թե որքան գորուստ որքաներ գորուսներուն եւ գարվածներուն արժեքը, սակայն այսօր եթե այսօրվա ճապանիշներով, այսօրվա միջազգային ճապանիշներով վերարժեվորում պիտի կատարվի մեր գորուսներուն, ապա անոնք կդարուբերին 50-ն 90 միլիարդ դոլարի հասնող արժեքի։
There is another group in Armenia which has also made some evaluation of claims, and they reach very incredible numbers because they consider, in fact, what I told you before, what could have been the situation if the genocide didn't happen. First, and the second element that they add is the harm caused by the other countries or the benefits that other countries made thanks to the genocide. And they reach an incredible number of $3 trillion. And half of it on the account of Turkey. But then they also claim from Great Britain, from France, from Germany, from all the countries which have been involved in some state. Here you can see all the difference between the evaluations. And so before it has been said, but I told you again, but very firmly, I mean, the CEF treaty has no legal existence, okay? You can consider that it does not exist because it has never been ratified. And since it has not been ratified, so it never had any entry in force. Իրական ուժ երբեք չունեցավ. But all the records from the CEF treaty or from the Paris Peace Conference are there. I mean, they have not been invented. So this is material. I mean, we can use all these materials. Now, what does it mean? So the third pillar is the satisfaction. So satisfaction is not to get satisfied of pleasure or what. Satisfaction in law has a certain meaning. So satisfaction, this is where you will have all the moral reparation. And the moral reparation in our case can be very wide. It started by an apology from Turkey. It can be also the recognition of their guilt. And here, when I say that, they are not obliged to recognize the word genocide. This is not what we are asking there. They can just recognize that they have been, in fact, responsible for the massacres and deportations. And I just would like to highlight here that they don't deny these massacres, they don't deny these deportations. On the contrary, they are recognizing. Of course, they put some circumstances to justify it, but they don't deny it. And if you look at the Perinçek case that Virgin mentioned before, in the Perinçek Grand Chamber decision, you have some elements which are clearly written. The government of Turkey does not deny the massacres and deportations. So we have already all the elements to go for that. I mean, they have recognized their crime. They just don't want to qualify it as genocide. And that's why in my article I have mentioned that the dispute about the genocide word or concept is totally irreal for me, because we are stuck on this, we are losing time, while for reparation we are already late. We are already late, and I will come on this. So in satisfaction you also have corrective measures. For an example, to impose that all the text books in school in Turkey are changed. You have so many that the denial stops. All these measures can be part of the reparation package. And of course, this is our role to claim for that. But this is also the role of countries that may enter into this process, because this is in the interest of everybody. And there are two other pillars in this reparation definition in international law, which is rehabilitation measures, but this is not appropriate for Armenians. And there is another pillar, which is the guarantees that the history will not be repeated, non-repetition of what happened. So that's reparation. Now let's move to another aspect. Of course, Virginie made a statement. She cannot know what is going on, but so I hope she will be satisfied. There is a group of experts which exists. Probably the best international expert at the moment which is working, in fact, under my coordination on the Armenian case since 5 years. But of course, we don't make publicity about that. We are discussing in depth of many legal obstacles that we have, and also about the right jurisdiction where to go for the claims. So this was, in fact, the last meeting we had was the last 2 days in Geneva. So I had organized a quite important meeting with 25 really the most knowledgeable people, most experienced people in such cases, to try to find some solutions. And among these experts, there were judges from the European Court, from the International Court of Justice. So academics, which that's their job. I mean, and they were here like academics just to try to find some solutions. So this is important. So there is some professional work which is done, but it is not known, in fact, to everybody. And now here I disagree with, in fact, with Virgin on this point. When we talk about reparations, we cannot split diaspora and Armenia. For me, this is not relevant. I mean, we are talking here about the victims of a genocide. We are not talking about diaspora or Armenia or Turkey. I mean, we are descendants of one nation. I would like to remember, Virgin, that half of the population in Armenia comes from Western Armenia, from Ottoman Empire. I mean, you cannot split people like this, so there will not be. It's not possible to envisage one action in diaspora, one action in Armenia. That's impossible. In the Armenian genocide case, it should be one unique action for the reparation of collective harm for the genocide issue. As far as the individual claims, this is a different story. If some of you here have some title deeds, some property deeds, you can go in the Turkish court. And I really encourage you to do that. You can go, and things are changing a little bit in the Turkish court about this. This is not yet. I don't think that some cases have really happened recently as individual claims, but they are ongoing. This is pending in the courts. Of course, Turkey is trying to put some legal obstacles, procedural obstacles, but now you have in Turkey some Turkish lawyers who see a good way to make a lot of money on our back, and so they start, in fact, being very active in claiming the properties, restitution of properties for Armenians. And even they have access to cadastral registries, which are forbidden. So they have access to the registries, they take the names of landowners or property owners, and then they go and look for the descendants to propose them the claim.
Is there any example?
Yes, of course. Yes. And because I am in contact with these lawyers, and they asked me to find the descendant of very precise names. And they do that, so not only for individuals, but at the moment they are doing that also for the churches. So for an example, the Patriarchate of Jerusalem did start this process. They asked the lawyers to find all the properties belonging to the churches which were under their tutorship, trustship, administration. Yes. By the way, at this point, I would like to say that, for an example, there is one organization in France which is making a lot of noise and asking for the restitution of all national assets, including churches, and to transfer. So they asked to Erdogan and the Turkish government to restitute all these assets and put them under the trustship of the Patriarchate of Constantinople. I want to say this is a totally illegal claim. I mean, they have no mandate for that. And this is what Virgin was saying. You need some legitimacy to ask for this. I mean, who in Armenia or in diaspora can claim national assets in the name of everybody, especially to put it in the basket of Patriarchate of Constantinople, which is just an agent of the Turkish government. This is stupid. This is really stupid. So they have no legitimacy, and more than that, they are dispossessing the real owners of the properties. I mean, And you will see, because I have seen prior to this publication justification of a leader of this organization, he is even blaming the Catholicos Aram of Gidigia to have put a claim without taking the authorization of Patriarchate of Constantinople. What does it mean? I mean, Catholicos of Antedias is the owner of a land. Why he should ask authorization to anybody for claiming his property? So this is really an incredible situation. So here I would like to now come to the point which is really important. That shows that when we will come to the reparation process, we will see a lot of bad things. Because people will see money, others will try to put forth their own organization to show that they are leading the process, This is where we really need a centralized decision-making organ. It will be impossible to control every individual claim, and this is not reasonable to think like that. But there is one thing which is important. Nobody has the right to put in danger the reparation of a genocide, even if we don't call it genocide, just because of individual claim. So that means that everybody has the right to claim for his property, but certainly not to put in danger the whole case, I mean the collective case. So, second good news for you, Virgin. there is a coordination group which has been established in Yerevan. This is just an information sharing group, but still, this is important. So there is a group which where are present different organizations, also some of the lawyers who are interested in such cases at the moment, and we share information just to avoid this a wrong initiative, a judicial initiative. Because I would like to tell you that in the Perinçek case, we have been really in a situation of big threat for the genocide. Because at the chamber decision, all the historical consensus of the reality of genocide has been challenged by the court. It was really bad, really, really bad. That's why it was important that all the organization and the Armenian government tries to be party in this case. Why did I start this?
Legitimacy of...
Yes. Yes, so in fact there is this coordination group, so here you have the spiritual authorities, lawyers, you have ANCA from United States, you have the Armenian Assembly of America, lawyer, you have different institutions and individual experts, all Armenian. The most, and this is under the chairmanship of the president of the Constitutional Court. And of course, you have also some young lawyers from Armenia, quite good lawyers. I'm sure that, for example, the National Congress of Western Armenians is also present in this coordination group. I suppose you know that, no? Mr. Gregorian and Mikhailian. Yeah? You know that you are present in this coordination group? Do you know that?
No.
No?
Yeah?
I was just telling you.
Այո,
չէ, գսեթե Երևանի մեջ խումբը առաջացած է բանի համագործակցության խումբը առաջացած է Հայաստանի Սահմանադրական Սադարանի նախագահի գլխավորությամբ եւ այդ խումբի մեջ նաեւ ԱՌՄԴ Հայաստանի կոնգրեսը ներկայացված է երկու անուններով Միքայելյան
եւ
Սուրենի մասին, այո, այո։ Հետո։ Համաձայն եմ, որ կոյասուցի չէ, բայց ամենեն կարևոր բանն է, որ դերեկությունը, ինիցիատիվները հոս հոն ջանսված է լան, որբեսի սխալներ չլան, միայն աս է նպատակը է թխումպից։ Donc, so now the most important is in fact to start a real First of all, to take a decision, a political decision, to go for the claims. This is the most important. And again, I argue that as long as Armenia will stay away, this will be very difficult for organization in diaspora to manage this claim process alone, because we won't have any jurisdiction to go for before. Now some people are saying, yeah, but this is a legal approach. And they don't believe in legal approach. They are right. The legal approach is just to try to push Turkey to enter into a political process. This is the goal. I mean, everybody knows that justice and law are just, say, illusions, especially in international law. I can give you some examples. Everybody is talking about the Jewish claims. Okay. Well, as you know, Germany and Israel have signed an agreement, direct agreement between states for compensation of victims of Holocaust. But besides this, individuals. So Jewish individuals have started claims to get some assets. So one of the most famous cases is the case of Jewish descendants of victims of the Holocaust in the US, when they started to claim restitution of their family assets in the Swiss banks. It was in 1996. So the claim started initially by the resolution of some congressmen, so some political people from the United States, and then some Jewish lawyers started to get interested into this because they saw a lot of money at the end of the process. They started the process without having clients claiming for these assets. They had no clients. I mean, they started the process directly without having clients. And when it made a lot of noise, then lawyers get some clients to support their claims. And one statement, so the Subsecretary of Commerce in the United States, Stuart Eisenstadt, has been nominated as a mediator between the Swiss bank, which were refusing to give any money, and so the Jewish claimants. And this is, in fact, at the end of the day, a pure political pressure of United States government over the Swiss banks. The United States government said to the Swiss bank, if you don't accept to sign a deal with the Jewish claimants, then you will have economic sanctions from the United States. Okay. So this is how they reached an agreement. And of course, once they reached the agreement, then they made it signed by the judge who was in charge of the case. So this was not a real judicial process, but the first claims helped the political process, and this is what should be aimed in our case. I mean, since we are today in a political impasse with Turkey, we need now to start, in fact, seriously the legal claims, and then let's see how where it will go. But this is very important to start it. If not, nothing will happen. Never. Now, is the reparation only a financial aspect? So here again, there are many experiences showing that no, it's not only a pure financial issue, a monetary issue. Because in the end, what do we expect? At least it is my personal opinion, but I mean, not. I'm sure that many Armenians are thinking like that. What we expect, and this is proper to any criminal case, what the victims or the descendants of victim expect is that the murderer recognize its guilt. This is the most important in a criminal case. As long as the murderer or the criminals don't recognize their guilt, then there is no real moral satisfaction on the victim side. And I can give you one example of this. Have you heard of this Korean woman who have been forced to prostitution during the invasion of a Japanese army in Korea? Okay. So the forced prostitution happened from 1930 to 1945 until the end of the Second World War. So imagine. So we are not very far from our case because the reparation process started. I mean, reached one agreement in 1995. That means 50 years after the end of the Second World War. The agreement was a decision of a Japanese government to say, well, we apologize. We encourage the creation of a special fund for compensation of victims. But the problem is that it was not a state fund. They asked the citizens of Japan to put money in this fund for so compensating the victims. Why is that? Because Japan didn't want to recognize officially its responsibility in the crime. Said this is not, it was not a state crime. This happened because men are men and so on, but they didn't recognize their guilt and their responsibility. And this is only so in December last year that a final agreement again came, where so they went a step further, and the Japanese government this time decided to pay to the fund from the state budget, which gives another symbolic. So as long as the state of Japan accept to pay, when you accept to pay, that means that you recognize, in fact, your responsibility. But look, I mean, we are 85 years after the beginning of a crime. So that gives some hope about, yes.
Within this issue that we are discussing it, well, what about the AXA? When all those people who were members of American Life Insurance, they got compensated with their papers. In LA,
But some of the people have been compensated.
Almost 100 and 150 families.
Yeah, but this is a difference. But because this is individual claims, they ask assets. AXA was a French insurance company.
It was something to be mentioned.
Yeah, no, but of course, there are New York Life Insurance before that, of course. But the French AXA accepted politically to, but this is not a recognition of anything. I mean, this is a natural claim for getting the money. Unfortunately, this AXA claim process shows a very bad example for
I just mentioned it because you told us that not individuals can mention it.
Sorry?
Right.
Non, mais ça, je vais y venir. We you will raise the question afterwards, okay? Because I don't understand what you are meaning. But in this case, this is a good example of what we should avoid in the future, because unfortunately, the AXA case is a very bad case for as an example for Armenians, because some money has been how you say
Swelo.
Stolen,
detourné.
And there is a prosecution ongoing against the Armenian advocates who did that at the moment. That shows that in the big claim case for Armenians, it's probably better that we subcontract to a professional lawyer firm, even if it costs some, but just to make sure that we are not, there is no suspicious so operations behind that. This is my opinion, and I advocate for this. I come back to the case of Korean woman, but this is not the only one. For an example, the native Indians in America never accepted the money that the U.S. government provided them individually, because the U.S. government never accepted its responsibility in the genocide of the native Indians in the United States. And still now, they apologized, okay, but they don't recognize their responsibility, because this was in the philosophy of the United States of America to conquer the West, and they were ready for everything for that. So they deported, massacred the Indians just to get the lands to the West. This is a terrible lesson for the history, because but that shows that the United States of America is playing with law as he wants, but everybody knows that. They are good to ask the others to repair, but they are not good to repair themselves. So maybe I should stop here, but what I would like to say is that there is a professional work which has been done and which is ongoing. There is a coordination group in Yerevan. What we have to avoid are the individual initiatives which may endanger the global case, the genocide case. And we really need pan-Armenian decision to go for this claim process, because it will have an influence over the activities of all the Armenian communities in the world. Because we have to orient our activity in convincing countries like France, like Germany, like United States, to push for this claim process. If not, we will stay in a very defensive situation of because this is a defensive situation to fight for recognition of genocide by other countries. I don't say that we should stop that, but we should not limit ourselves to this, because this is a no end politics. This is no end because you put $1, Armenians will put $1, Turkish people, Turkish state will put $10 to counter the action of Armenians. So this is a no end process. And as far as, so maybe I can finish also on the territorial claims. The reparation process for genocide excludes the territorial claims. Why? Because the territorial claims can be only, first of all, interstate issue, and nobody else can interfere in territorial claims. And secondly, you need some treaties to enforce these claims. So here, there is a big controversy about the validity of Wilson arbitration. So some people, but very few, to be honest, Ara Papian in Armenia, Henri Theriot and his group in the United States supported this initiative. I mean, they tried to demonstrate that the Wilson arbitration is valid independently on the invalidity of a safe treaty. They put some legal arguments, okay, which can be discussed, but I can bring them other arguments which are not theoretical arguments, but just decisions from the International Court of Justice, which defeat immediately their arguments. So this is really a very romantic situation to claim that the Wilson arbitration is valid. But again, I mean, it doesn't mean that Armenia should not keep this argument in its future policy. But today, legally, I mean, there is no link between territorial claim and the genocide. So now I can take the questions.
What about the Armenian protocols that they signed